So guys, this is Notion for web. If you're not new to Notion, if you are brand new to Notion, feel free to check out the Skillshare class that we've got. We'll include it in the link below. So what I want to show you guys is a little bit about how I've approached resolutions and goals in 2019. And what I want to say with this is it's actually super not important when you do this. If you want to plan for 2019 in June time, it doesn't matter. And also what I want to say is these goals and thoughts as well are totally opportunities to change stuff. So you don't necessarily have to stick with stuff. You can really just adapt it as you go along. And naturally, you're still following that same path. The goal is really to get things moving. So I'm going to show you a template that I created near the end of 2018 and give you a bit of an idea on what I think and how it will be useful for you. Now, the thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to make this available to you guys as some template to basically get you started, because I know sometimes it can be tricky. Notion actually doesn't allow you at the moment to copy that, but you can actually just use it for reference instead of waiting in this video, pausing it every 5 seconds. So what I did in 2019, and what I did actually is make this, the real page is available in personal at the top, so I can click into it and I can get access to it at any time. Now, what I want to demonstrate to you guys is the sort of the simplistic approach I've gone with this. So you can see here that I've created something called a gallery, and that can be really easily created. If I press slash inside of Notion and type in gallery, you can create a gallery in line. And as you can see, these sort of pages appear. And once you click in, you're able to access that page and edit it. And what I've simply done up here is I've simply created this and actually just started modifying what's inside it. Now, the great thing is it previews what's already in there. So I've actually got from January to June to some extent, because I haven't actually added my June goals into here. So it allows me to actually plan 6 months ahead. You can actually have this for 12 if you wanted to. All you'd have to do is press plus and a new month would appear. And you could, for example, add July. And as you can see, a new month's appear. And when I can start adding stuff, for example, if I added a subheader, subheader focus, it appears inside of there. So that's really nice. And you actually have the ability to plan all 12 months or however long you want. So the great thing is, for example, this is my 2019 plan for the next 6 months. If I click in, I've got two things. I've got a focus and I've got an achievement area. So my focus is, launch ProdCon. Okay, so I've actually done that one. I could probably turn that one into a tick box and tick it off. Hopefully it all went very well. And as you can see here, this is the new area. So I, for example, launched the Skillshare class with a student. So I can drag that one down into achievements and drag that one down there too. So you can start to see the idea. I've got my focus. I've got maybe 5 to 6, 7 things that I want to focus in on January and really to help channel that and keep track of the achievements. So I've tried to do that with a couple of months in advance. Obviously, this isn't my full one, so it's something that obviously will change. But for example, you can have absolutely anything in there. If you wanted to have like travel plans, or you wanted to have like work goals, or even health or finance goals would be a good way to plan ahead. So it's really up to you on what you have in there. Now, what I actually did to create these different sections is I really simply created a subheader. So for example, if I were to create this from scratch, so for example, if I tried to make it to July one, I'd go and add an icon. I don't really mind what the icon is. I pressed slash subheader and I typed in focus. I then went down and pressed slash subheader achievements. So if I go to focus, all I'd have to do is color this one and go down to yellow background. And the same with the achievements area. I'd have to go down to green background. And I really simply created it without having too much of a hiccup there. So for example, if I wanted to ask myself, for example, when's March coming up and you solely want to see March, you can do that quite easily. Now, this isn't like a calendar. This is very simple. It's a gallery ability. And you can change it up. For example, you could add your own view if you wanted to, but I don't necessarily recommend it. If you wanted to add a table or a list view, you could do. So for example, if I created it into a table, you'd be able to see an outline of the months there. But in this case, it looks pretty good as a gallery because it's very visual. When you come into the page, you can actually see a few of the things that you've got prompted for this year. Now, okay, so that's the 2019 planning. And really what I recommend from my own experience is that you set yourself 5 to 6 things a month that you want to work on. Now, if you're really looking for a thing to guide you before you do this, and I definitely did the first thing, all targets, before I actually did the gallery planning. So what I recommend doing is creating something like this. So this is a page called All Targets, and it's got a few toggle lists here. And it basically breaks down the different areas. I sat down at the end of the year and I went, okay, what areas of my life could I improve and how can I make them better? So what I did is I broke it down into social, finance, career, health, and habits in an attempt to really reduce the amount of negative habits and improve the amount of positive habits across the board. So let's start with social. I think social is important. Maybe you can get some inspiration from this. Just to let you know, I actually got inspiration from someone on Twitter who did this. So I actually stole this idea completely from them. I'll try and reference them below so you guys can take advantage of it. But it's a similar technique in being able to just uncover what you want to work on in specific areas of your life. So let's open up social. You can see here that I've set myself about, I think it's about 6 different targets. So for example, it says send meaningful messages to family and friends. I am typically quite slow at replying, and also my messages are really fast and I would like to improve that, and I'm trying to at the moment. The second thing is to be more positive overall. I want to be more positive overall in terms of like my approach to things. You can obviously see some of these are quite general, and what I want to do across a year and what I recommend that you do is hone in on them, make them more actionable. These are more just statements, they're sort of like a guideline versus necessarily actionable stuff. So evenings past 5 p.m. I don't want to stay up past 5 p.m. working, and they must only be for podcasts. So for example, that's something I want to do that will improve my social aspect. Switch off iPhone before bed and bring it to another room. I'm still challenging with this one because I guess having a phone near you in case something happens in the night, it's good because obviously it's security. But again, I bought myself an alarm clock. So a small alarm clock that will help me get up instead of necessarily using my phone. So my phone isn't the first thing to touch in the morning and get distracted by. The second thing is log 2 entries into daily journal per day. You can just modify this, click per day. So also you've got there, become a top product hunter. So that's a good social goal apparently. So that's sort of my social area. I designed that based on a sitting down with an A3 piece of paper and just saying to myself, what can you do in 2019 to really enhance your social life? Okay, so the same with finance. So I open up finance and I can see, for example, it would be reach XX sales in my business or in my freelancing efforts. Or it could be your salary, like aim for a XX $1,000 salary per year. So for example, you can set yourself a financial goal. This could be, for example, like saving a goal. So for example, like save $1,000 a month or $300 a month. Yeah, whatever it is, it's an opportunity for you to set yourself a target and review every single month. Now, the other thing I did is only spend what I must. This is something that obviously correlates to the second one, reduce all overheads monthly. Spending what I must is quite an important one to me because this year I want to be a bit more intentional in what I actually spend my money on. The same with reducing overheads monthly. So I basically printed out my bank statements for the last 3 months, and I essentially wanted to sit down with it and circle the things that I could potentially remove. And we'll talk about this later in terms of habit side of stuff. But this was actually a really good practice for me, and I can't recommend it enough, because when you've got your bank card and you're swiping it across, you don't take into account, it's very difficult to take into account what you actually spend your money on. There are apps that can help you to fine tune that and actually see what you're spending your money on. But still, sometimes when you're out and about, you don't necessarily think about it. So I looked at it and I said, okay, where can I reduce any overheads that I have monthly? And that practice was really beneficial. And I am actually going to be doing that monthly now. And that's something that I've really found beneficial. So introduce more passive income strategies. Again, very general and opportunistic, but it actually gives me a focus for this year. Also, save XX amount outside of mortgage. So it's an opportunity for me to, work a bit harder to get some extra income. So, for example, in Korea, I have achieved 1,500 subscribers. So if you're not subscribed to the YouTube channel, do, because you'll help reach that goal. I've also got maximize all YouTube space opportunities. One thing I'm worried about doing is not taking advantage of all of that. So, I want to make that a career goal. Also release 10 main courses, and that will be a way to boost the finance side of it too. Also grow the blog to the monthly visits. So this could be an opportunity for you to sit down and go, for example, let's say you're in an internship or you're actually working in a full-time role, is looking at whether you want to get a promotion or something like this, or even you just want to be able to improve your income or develop a certain amount of sales for your team. It doesn't matter what it is, it's an opportunity for you to progress yourself in your career. So that's end of year goals really. And I can modify that as I go, make it more fine-tuned. So, health habits. So I've got do not eat after 8 p.m., gremlin style. That's just something I've been reading about. Obviously, the negatives to eating after 8 p.m. can not be so good. Sleep 8 hours a day. Trying to do this one, 7.5 at the moment. Only box one time a week. I'm not sure why I added that one, because I'm boxing like 3 times a week and it's working beautifully. So maybe like only box 4 times a week. So that's an opportunity for you to set yourself some limits or some goals. Work out a healthy, balanced body. So that's an opportunity to do that. And also only eat 1 sugar items a day, which is going to be a challenge. So you can set yourself a few health goals. They don't have to be like this, but they can get the ball rolling. And it can be a bit more specific. So for example, it could be like bench press 100 kilograms. I don't know how much that is. Do 4 core workouts every single week, and that can help feed into your good stuff. So let's open up the habit side of stuff. So I do 2 really bad habits. I bite my fingernails and bite my cheeks too, which is really bad. But it's an opportunity for me to flag myself up on that and actually keep a track of it. So week to week, when I look at this, I can go, all right, how good have I been in these categories? Also, intentional browsing on Twitter, unintentional browsing. Again, this is something that I don't want to be doing and something I want to crush. So these are negative habits. Also, checking analytics every few times a day. That's really something that I know a lot of people do when they've started a side project, but it's really unnecessary. Buying clothes and not tactically wearing them. So for example, fine-tuning my use of clothes. I noticed recently I've been really only wearing shirts and they last me a longer. So, working out what is better for your efforts, Completing low-value tasks, only intentional. That's something I've been doing but negatively with my to-do list, is actually just completing small things versus going for big things. And spending, I want to only spend up to £55 in coffee shops a month. I work remotely, so that's going to be a lot better. So you can see this. You can make this list for your own. Really simply, all you have to do is type in toggle list and then write the category. And you actually have to import the, go to Emojipedia and copy these in, because they actually won't be able to do that. Once you've done that, you can add some bullet points below and add your own ideas. So it's really a simple method. So what I do with my week review, for those who don't know, I sit down every Thursday and I open up my goals inside of Notion, plan my week inside of Todoist, and really get an idea for what I need to get done. So I opened, when I first started this one, and what I recommend doing is create this one first, the all targets, then populate this, and then week to week, sit down and go, okay, in January, am I on target to complete all of these goals? And I can go, okay, yes or no. No, if I'm no on a lot of those, then what can I be doing to improve that? And if I'm yes, then that's fantastic. What can I do to make sure I absolutely nail that one or over-exceed it? And if I need to, and what I also try to do is go to all targets, read down this list, and just get an idea of what I can be doing to reduce that. So guys, that's my approach to goals and resolutions in 2019. Let me know what you thought of it. Honestly, it'd be great to hear some of your opinions. Naturally, I will make this available as a mini template, I guess, or page that you can go away and check out. Of course, I will be developing this, and I don't recommend necessarily that this is the be-all and end-all you know, you could create this if you're getting started, but absolutely make your own methodology around it if it's something you're struggling with. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for attending ProdCon today. Honestly, I was the last talk today, number 9, but I didn't include myself. I wanted to make this a bonus one, really. Honestly, I can't thank you enough for coming to ProdCon. It's been something that I'll probably look to release back in April if you guys enjoyed it. If you enjoyed it, that is. And I really do would love to have you back. So thank you very much, everyone. Make sure to have a great day. Keep productive and make sure you can come back to ProdCon over the next 7 days if you want to learn or miss any of the talks and jump back in. Anyway, guys, thank you so much, and I will see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.